Welcome to Mesa Encore Theater's third virtual cabaret. My name is David Chorley. I'll be your host this evening. And I hope everyone's doing safe, doing well, being safe during this really crazy, unbelievable time. I know myself, I'm doing just fine. I haven't left my house in 18 days. And normally that's not how I would start off a show, by admitting to a bunch of people that fact. But I'm strangely proud of it, and thus is the time that we live. So again, I hope you're all doing really great, and glad to provide a little entertainment today. I understand that everyone is sort of in the same boat here. In fact, there's probably a lot of people out there in the universe that have far worse stories than us. Hello there, everybody. How are you doing? My name is David Chorley. I am the artistic director here at Mesa Encore Theater, and that's really good to see everybody. Even though I can't see you, you can see me, and I know half of you are in your pajamas. It's okay. You can admit it. I'm in my pajamas too. Haven't left the house in 18 days, and normally that's not how I like to start off a show, by admitting to a bunch of strangers that unusual fact, but thus is the time we live in. So I'm glad to be providing some entertainment for everybody on behalf of Mesa Encore Theater. We have seven amazing performers for you today. I'm very excited to get to them. But before we go a little bit further, I hope everyone's doing safe and doing well during this, this unusual pandemic situation that we're in. I know that everyone is in the same boat, and that Mesa Encore Theater is just one of literally millions of stories out there. Everyone is affected by this in their own way. So keep that in mind, of course, but all arts organizations are in this same boat together. You know, everybody that is a theater or in the performing arts in some way just can't do anything right now. For Mesa Encore Theater, you know, a third of our season is in the spring. And we had to cancel two of our shows in the spring. That's a third of our season. So right now we have no revenue coming in at all, just like all theaters. So we're trying to think outside of the box a little bit, and that's what led us to our cabaret. This is our third. And basically where I'm going with this is you can donate. You can donate throughout this cabaret today. You can tip your singers at our Venmo account, which is Mesa-Encore Theater, Mesa-Encore Theater. Go ahead and tip us when you can. All of those proceeds go directly to Mesa Encore Theater to help us pay the bills that still are coming in, even when we're not doing anything. So again, Mesa-Encore Theater is our Venmo account. Now, today we have a great lineup. Our cabaret theme is When I Grow Up. We've asked seven young singers, all under the age of 17, to come up with songs that inspire them. What would they do when they grow up? So really looking forward to that. It just brings me back to when I was a little kid and I was thinking what I wanted to do when I grew up. And I've always wanted to host virtual cabarets. And here I am. So I've literally done exactly what I wanted to do. And I think I've peaked, unfortunately. It's actually a little sad. But anyway, we have seven beautiful young girls. No boys are performing tonight. No boys. And that is because I have just learned that boys have cooties. And I didn't know that until my wife showed me. I actually had cooties and she showed me, and they were really kind of gross. So ladies, be very, very, very lucky that you do not have cooties. And without further ado, let's go ahead and get this show on the road. First up today, we have Maddie Sue Miller. Maddie Sue, she is a fifth grader. Okay, so hey, can you better than a fifth grader? She would answer no, because I'm a fifth grader, I'm honest. Matt Sue, school, she has been appearing in a variety of shows around town. She was in Matilda at Valley Youth Theater. That's my alma mater. I am a VYT kid, so you know she's got some talent. And then she played Molly and Annie over at Hale, and we're very, very excited to have her. So Maddie Sue's going to be kicking things off with an apropos song called When I Grow Up from the musical Matilda. Maddie Sue, go ahead and take it away.
When I grow up,
Great job, Maddie Sue. Fantastic. What a great way to kick things off. Hey, don't forget to tip Maddie Sue. All right, tip your singers at our Venmo account, which is Mesa-Encore Theater. If you are viewing this live stream from our webpage at MET, you can actually scroll down to the bottom of that live stream page and you'll find a link where you can donate there as well if you do not have a Venmo account. So there's multiple ways to donate. If you're on the webinar, give us a chat. Send any questions our way as well. We'd love to get donations if possible from anywhere. Next up is Parker Pitt. Parker is a 9-year-old who is going to be starting the Arizona School of the Arts next year. MET audiences will be extremely familiar with Parker because she was just in our last show, which was Shrek the Musical. And I have the pleasure of hearing her sing I Know It's Today 59 times. I sang it. It was great. It never got old. I would just sit there and smile watching her sing, and the girl never messed up once. I mean, I've already messed up like 9 times just doing this hosting gig. She is a great, great performer. We're so very lucky to have her for future productions as well. So singing Naughty again for the musical Matilda, please welcome Parker Pitt.
Jack and Jill went up the hill to fetch a pair of Wu-Tang. So they say the subsequent fool was never trouble. They never stood a chance, they were written that way. Innocent victims of that story. Like Romeo and Juliet, 'twas written in the stars before they even met. That love and fate and a touch of stupidity would rob them of the hope of living happily. The endings are often a little bit gory. I wonder why they didn't just change their story. We're told we have to do what we are told, but surely. Sometimes you have to be a little bit naughty. Just because you find that life's not fair, it just means that you just have to grin and bear it. If you always take it to the tin and wear it, nothing will change. Even if a little you can do alone, you mustn't let a little thing like a little stop you. If you sit around and let them get on top of you, you might as well be saying you think that it's okay. And that's not right. And if it's not right, you have to put it right. Let him not head up, extra strong. Keep out of reach of children. Oil and violence hair tonic. For men. Yep. In a slip of a bolt is a tiny revolt, the seed of a wall and a creak of a floorboard. A storm can begin with a flap of a wing. The tiniest mite packs the mightiest sting every day. Starts with the tick of a clock, all escapes. Starts with the click of a lock. If you're stuck in your story, it won't get out. You don't have to cry, you don't have to shout, because it's a little you can do alone. You mustn't let a little thing like a little stop you. If you sit around and let them get on top of you, won't change a thing. Just because you find that life's not fair, it doesn't mean that you just have to grin and bear it. If you always take it on the chin and wear it, you might as well be saying you think that it's okay, and that's not right. And if it's not right, you have to put it right. But nobody else is gonna put it right for me. Nobody but me is gonna change my story. Sometimes you have to be a little bit naughty.
What'd I tell you? I didn't think it could get any cuter. And then at the very end, she did one of these deals. She just, and then, oh yeah. I mean, oh, my heart is melting. Parker, really, really nice job. All right, up next we have Lachlan. Lachlan will be singing every other song from Matilda. So we're just gonna do all of the songs from Matilda. I'm just kidding, actually. Lachlan is an eighth grader from Mountainside Middle School, but she's currently going to Zoom University. And I don't want to take credit for that joke. I think Lachlan's mom wrote that joke, but it was really, really funny, Susie. Now, Lachlan is a three-time NYA winner. She's also won a Zony already. She's really, really talented. And when she grows up, her dream role is to play Miss Hannigan in Annie. And, you know, I'm just kind of thinking off the cuff here, Lachlan, but why wait? I mean, I think we could make this work. I think you could play Miss Hannigan now. Wait. We could do a production at MET where all of the adults are the orphans and then all the kids are the adults. I love it. I'm having a vision here. Anyway, I'm gonna work on this idea. Okay, I think we can workshop it. While I'm working on it, please enjoy Lachlan Henderson singing Someday from The Wedding Singer. Take it away, Lachlan.
Haze. They share a smile and a secret wave. It's a moment built to save. She starts to move across the floor. The room is frozen, wanting more. The happy couple on display, with nothing standing in their way. It's so romantic, I could die right here and now. It's gonna be that way for us. I know somehow, someday when it's me, although our love was meant to be, not one single complication or cause for hesitation. Someday when the dream is coming true, all you need is me, and all I need is you. They stop and pose for a photograph. He jokes around just to make her laugh. The room is full, but they're all alone. They have a language of their own. And I'm so jealous, I could cry, and yet I know it won't be long before you say, we're good to go. Someday when it's me, although our love was meant to be, not one single complication or cause for hesitation. Someday when the dream is coming true, all you need is me, and all I need is you. I know not every marriage lasts when things go bad. I've seen the warning signs, I call them mom and dad. But soon you'll take my hand and pledge your love to me. Till then I'll just get married vicariously. Someday when it's me, I'll know our love was meant to be. Not one single complication or cause for hesitation.
all I need is you.
Outstanding, Lachlan. That was so great. Really, really well done. Don't forget to tip our performers. Tip Lachlan. You can tip your singers tonight at Venmo at Mesa-Encore Theater. That is a Venmo account that goes straight to Mesa Encore Theater. Any little bit helps. If you're watching this from our live stream website, at the very bottom, you can scroll down and there is a link to donate there as well. Again, some revenue is better than no revenue. All right, that is our tagline for the rest of the month. Anyway, I was just looking at Lachlan's bio, and she had also said that one of her dream roles was to play Grisabella in Cats. And again, I'm just full of ideas right now. I mean, what if MET could do like a production of Cats with just all young performers? Would it technically be Kittens? I mean, could we just change the name to Kittens and just have just a bunch of little kids running around? Probably better than the movie. I just saw that the other day and it made quarantine a lot worse. Anyway, up next we have Taya Berman. Taya is a sixth grader. Now she goes to Scottsdale Prep. She's very, very active in the local valley, in the theater scene. Her parents are also very active with Mesa Encore Theater, and we're so excited to have her and her talents with us tonight. She's gonna be singing Wonderful from High School Musical, the series. So Taya, whenever you're ready, you take it away.
Seems like a part of me will always have to lose. Every single time I have to choose. Swore that I was right, but was I wrong? Is this where I'm supposed to be at all? I don't have the answers, not today. Just like nothing makes the questions go away. What I'd give to see if the grass was greener on the other side. If all I had and lost, would it be enough? Or would I still be wondering? If I could go back and change the past and be a little braver than I had and bet against the odds, would I still be lost? Even if I woke up in my dreams, would there still be something I'm missing? If I had everything, would it mean anything to me? Feels like I might have broke the best thing that I had. I said too much to ever take it back. Scared I'll never find something as good. And would I even know it if I could? From the other side of all I had and lost, would it be enough? Or would I still be wondering? If I could go back and change the past and be a little braver than I had and bet against the odds, would I still be lost? Even if I woke up in my dreams, would there still be something I'm missing? If I had everything, would it mean anything? Maybe I should turn around and take the other road. Maybe I'm just looking for what I already know. I'm just wondering if I could go back and change the past and be a little braver than I had, bet against the odds, would I still be lost? Even if I woke up in my dreams, would there still be something and I miss him. He fired everything, wouldn't mean anything to me. Would it be enough? Or would I still be wondering? Thank you.
Man, what a set of pipes. Tay is a sixth grader, and I will never have a voice as good as that sixth grader right there. Truly, truly impressive. Thank you so much, Taya. Now, you may have noticed a slight change of background, and that is because Mace Encore Theater has a doozy of a lineup next Friday. We have been working on this for a couple of weeks now, and we are going to be presenting to you a live stream reading of the script for The Legend of Robin Hood. This was the script that we had all ready to go. We were actually auditioning for it, and it was on our season this year, but we had to suddenly cancel it because of COVID-19. Luckily though, I know a guy who knows a guy, and we know the author of the script. He is going to be participating in the live reading with us, and we have assembled a really, really, really awesome, amazing cast. So this would definitely be more on the adult side, not so much the children's side, but it's a really, really great script, a very, very interesting take on the story of Robin Hood, and we're so very, very excited to present that to you. It will only be the second time in its history that it's ever performed. And we're going to do that as a donation this Friday. Also, I just wanted to plug Nathan's book. Nathan is the author of the show. He also got the script published into a novel, came out last year. You can order it on Kindle, on Amazon, anywhere. It's called Nottingham. What does this mean, ladies and gentlemen? It means that it's really, really good. We're so very excited to bring that to you. So keep the donations coming in. I've seen a few donations already. Really, really much appreciated. Next up, we have Kira O'Connor. Kira is a junior at Seton Catholic Prep in Chandler, and she has many, many credits on her resume, some really good ones. Velma in Chicago, and Morticia in Adam's Family, and we're just really excited to have her perform for us today with MET. So Kira is going to be singing Used to Be Mine from a little show called Waitress. Kira, whenever you're ready, take it away.
Not simple to say, in most days I don't recognize me, that these shoes and this apron, that place and its patrons have taken more than I gave them. It's not easy to know I'm not anything like I used to be, although it's true I was never attention's sweet center. I still remember that girl. She's imperfect, but she tries. She is good, but she lies. She is hard on herself. She is broken and won't ask for help. She is messy, but she's kind. She is lonely most of the time. She's all of this mixed up and baked in a beautiful pie. She is gone, but she used to be mine. And it's not what I asked for. Sometimes life just slips in through a back door and carves out a person and makes you believe it's all true. and now I've got you. You're not what I asked for. If I'm honest, I know I would give it all back for a chance to start over and rewrite an ending or two. For the girl that I knew who'll be reckless just enough, who'll get hurt, but who learns how to toughen up when she's bruised and gets used by a man who can't love. And then she'll get stuck and be scared of the life that's inside her, growing stronger each day, till it finally reminds her to fight just a little, to bring back the fire in her eyes. That's been gone, but used to be mine. Used to be mine. She is messy, but she's kind. She is lonely most of the time. She is all of this mixed up and baked in a beautiful pie. She is gone, but she used to be mine. Fantastic,
Kira. That was so, so good. So many talented people. Kira, you've never done a show with MET, but please rethink that. Audition for us. That was really, really great. What a show so far. This is awesome. Go ahead and tip your performers. Go ahead and tip Kira. You can tip us at our Venmo account, which is Mesa-Encore Theater. There's also a link down below on our live streaming page for donations. I see a lot of donations coming in. A special shout out to Paige for her sizable donation just now. Very, very good of you. Thank you very, very much. Next up is Samantha. Samantha Gibbons is an MET regular, and she was just last seen in the Pirates of Penzance this season, but also had the lead role in She Kills Monsters, which is kind of different for her, and she was just fantastic. My first experience with Samantha is when I directed her in Mary Poppins. She played Jane, which is, you know, one of the two little kids. You know, and everyone thinks that Mary and Bert are the leads of that show, but I'm telling you what, those kids never leave the stage. Those kids are in every single scene. I'm not even joking. Rebecca is Samantha's mother, and I just felt so sorry for Rebecca, who had to drive Samantha to every single rehearsal, every single one, never got a night off. But anyway, it's really paid off because Samantha is wonderful. She just celebrated her sweet 16 and we're getting to see her grow up before our eyes. So before I cry, please welcome Samantha Gibbons singing Good Morning Baltimore from the musical Hairspray.
Oh, 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 woke up today feeling the way I always do. Oh, 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 hungry for something that I can't eat. Then I hear that tweet, the rhythm of town starts calling me down. It's like a message from high above. Oh, 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 pulling me out to the smiles and the streets that I love. Good morning, Baltimore. Every day's like an open door. Every night is a fantasy. Every sound's like a symphony. Good morning, Baltimore. And someday when I take to the floor, the world's gonna wake up and see. and me. Oh, 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 look at my hair. What you can compare with my today? Oh, 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 I've got my hairspray and radio. I'm ready to go. The rats on the street all dance round my feet. They seem to say, Tracy, it's up to you. So, oh, oh, don't hold me back, cause today all my dreams will come true. Good morning, Baltimore. There's the flasher who lives next door. There's the bum on his barroom stool. He wished me luck on my way to school. Good morning, Baltimore. And someday when I take to the floor, the world's gonna wake up and see Baltimore and me. I know every step, I know every song. I know there's a place where I belong. I see all those party lights shining ahead. So someone invite me before I drop dead. Oh, 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 give me a chance. Listen, I start to dance, I'm a movie star. Oh, 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 something inside of me makes me move. When I hear that groove, my ma tells me no. But my feet tell me go. It's like a drummer inside my heart. So, oh, oh, don't make me wait one more moment for my life to start. I love you, Baltimore. Every day's like an open door. Every night is a fantasy. Every sound's like a symphony. And I promise, Baltimore, that someday when I take to the floor, the world's gonna wake up and see. Gotta wake up and see. Baltimore and me. Baltimore and me. Baltimore and me.
Outstanding, Samantha. Great, great job. Don't forget to tip Samantha, Venmo, Mesa-Encore Theater. I see some more tips coming in through the website as well. Thank you to anyone that has donated so far. So we're going to get back to Lachlan Henderson. And funny story real fast about Lachlan. So she was in Shrek the Musical as well, which is the very last show MET performed last month. She played Teen Fiona. And if you've never seen the show, let me scene a little bit. So there's a song in which we see young Fiona, and then we see her grow up to a teen Fiona, and then we see the adult Fiona at the very end. Normally, that's the progression height. Well, Lachlan auditioned, and of course we had to use her, but she is the same exact height as the adult Fiona. In fact, if Lachlan was to let loose her hair, she'd actually be taller. So in our version, the young Fiona, and then she had a really big growth spurt, and then she just stopped growing and maybe crouched a little. So it was great. Parker and Lachlan were both fantastic in Shrek. So singing Parents Live from Freaky Friday, please help me in welcoming back Lachlan Henderson.
Parents lie, it's sad but true. Mine lied to me, yours lies to you. I lie to you. We say there's no monster there under your bed, but who knows? It's not like we search. And no one likes broccoli. We're all bad at flossing, and everyone's sleeping in church. And Buck the dog's not at a farm. Buck is dead. and Mom wasn't wrestling with Mike in their bed, and Santa Claus, well, just forget what I said. No, Santa's the shiz, and Santa knows just how it is. Oh, parents lie because they can. So learn the truth, my bright young man. They lie with words, they lie with acts. Parents lie, they lie like rugs. And parents will tell you you're great and special and stuff when clearly you're not. They say that one day you'll feel normal, but that's not enough. It's not by a lot. They'll hold you and tell you they love you and care, but they lie when they tell you they'll always be there. I know it's upsetting, but life isn't fair. And parents die. They tell you they won't, but they lie. Oh, parents lie. It's hard to hear. It's hard to say. It's true, I fear. It's fine to cry. It's sad, I know. Parents lie. But parents lie. So come on, here we are. Let's go.
Great job again, Glenn. Two in a row. You nailed it. Thank you so much. So anyone who is watching this, just know that we will probably replay this maybe several times. So you may not be watching it live necessarily, but that doesn't mean you cannot donate and tip these beautiful singers. You can tip us at any point at our Venmo account, which is Mesa-Encore Theater. And you can also scroll down to the live stream app if you're watching it live on our website and donate there. So thank you again to anyone who's made a donation. It really does make a difference. Up next, we have Kaylee Forth. She's a fifth grader from Haley Elementary School, and she actually already has a professional credit on her resume. She was one of the Von Trapps in Phoenix Theater's production of Sound of Music. When theater gets back up and running again, she'll be in Limelight's next production of The Wizard of Oz. And we're really, really excited to have Kaylee Forth here. My only regret is that she wasn't put fourth on this lineup today. She's actually going eighth. So joke is totally squandered. I don't know who put this lineup together, but a missed opportunity. So without further ado, here is Kaylee Forth singing Be Kind to Your Parents. Take it away, Kaylee.
Here's a piece of good advice. Think it over once or twice. Be kind to your parents, though they don't deserve it. Remember the grown-ups, a difficult stage of life. They're apt to be nervous and overexcited, confused from your daily storm and strife. Just keep in mind, though it sounds odd, I know. Most parents once were children long ago. Incredible! So treat them with patience and sweet understanding in spite of the foolish things they do. Someday you may wake up and find you're a parent too. Be kind to your parents, though they don't deserve it. Remember the grown-ups, a difficult stage of life. They're apt to be nervous and overexcited, confused from the daily storm and strife. Just keep in mind, though it sounds odd, I know. Most parents once were children long ago. Incredible! So treat them with patience and sweet understanding in spite of the foolish things they do. Someday you may wake up and find you're a parent too. No way. Thank you.
Love it. Loved it, Kaylee. Thank you so much. I don't know what it is about the kids' song versus the adult songs, but the kids' songs are like minutes or less. Like, hey, gotta get this done. I got video games to play. Great, great work, everybody. We got one more song, but before we get into that, I just give a quick update on Mesa Encore Theater. We are, of course, waiting on the governor, and we're just waiting on word that we're going to try to get back to normal. And once we get that word, we will start easing back into producing live theater for you. We do have a plan. We are just waiting until it's safe. We do know already that the Mesa Arts Center will be closed until at the earliest October 1st. So this is going to affect Mesa Encore Theater pretty good. The next months are going to be very, very different, a different time for MET, but it's okay. We have a great plan. Hopefully in June, we'll be able to start peppering in some smaller shows, Black Box, but the part of our season next year will look very different probably to what it does look now. But we will be updated, and just know that the second we know it's safe, MET is going to be back and better than ever. Okay, so keep your eyes peeled to our website, to our Facebook page for more information when that comes out. All right, so again, your last chance. Please don't forget to tip your performers. Venmo, Mesa-Encore Theater, that is our Venmo account. Goes straight to our bank account to help us through this time. I see a number of you have also made donations to our website. There's a link as well. Last up, we are bringing back Samantha Gibbons. She's going to be rounding this cabaret out, a doozy, and a very apropos song called I Just Want to Be a Star. Take it away, Samantha.
Very early age, I had to choose between the convent and my life upon the stage. So when Reverend Mother said we're putting on a show, I must tell you, I was thrilled to death. I couldn't wait to go. Well, not to my surprise, Reverend Mother didn't see. What's so obvious? The stage is meant for me. Money and fame I don't desire. I only want to sparkle. I'm not here to start a fire. You see, I don't care if I'm ever rich or famous. I just want to be a star. I don't care if you know what my name is, Robert. I just want to be a star. I want to be the nun who makes you cheer. The one who's out in front instead of in the rear. For once I want to lead the band and have the crowd in the palm of my hand. I don't care if I'm ever rich or famous, just so I can be a star. When began the show, they were really green. They didn't know a chorus line from a chorus queen. They didn't realize that in a chorus line, you never get to strut your stuff. You never really shine. I don't care if I'm ever rich or famous. I just want to be a star. I don't care that my only claim to fame is I got what it takes to be a star. I know my vow of poverty means I can't make a fortune, but when we're 80 and sitting on the porch in the old nun's home and they ask who we are, I just want to say, hey, I was a star. Care if I'm ever rich or famous, I just want to be. The chorus line is not for me. I'm red hot to be a star. Hey, Regina Park, your damn car. I just wanna be a star.
Samantha, you are a star. Thank you so much. In fact, all of the seven wonderful young ladies tonight are all stars, and stars in the making for sure. So I want to thank each and every one of them for having the courage to come out and performing. They were really, really solid. Very, very good. And it takes a lot of guts to do that. And you notice I didn't do any singing, thank goodness. But hey, that wraps things up. Just want to plug one last time, Mesa Encore Theater, this coming Friday, the 24th at 7:30. We're going to be doing the live stream reading of The Legend of Robin Hood. All star cast, really, really amazing actors from California and from Arizona, plus the author playwright is going to be participating as well. It's at 7:30. You can go to our Facebook page, our website to reserve a seat for that as well. And thanks for anyone who donated. Anything and everything is so much appreciated. So look at that, 48 minutes and we are done. These kids know how to do it, I'm telling you. Now we can all go eat and you know, there's still time to watch Antique Roadshow, which is at 7 p.m. And I think that's what most of us will be doing. Well, now you're gonna see how I'm spending my evening. Anyway, thank you so much for taking the time to join me tonight for our third of our cabaret. Keep your eyes peeled. Any future cabarets and events out this quarantine. Be safe out there. Thanks again. Have a good night.